Pomeroy Lodging Chuck Wagon coming into that render barrel number 3. Pomeroy Lodging, up in the northern part of our country, is your first choice for professional lodging and hotel rooms. It is Top Breaker. Then we'll go to that number 3 barrel. Top Breaker, in his third year of professional chuck wagon racing, honed his skills up in the Western Chuck Wagon Association up north, where his daddy and me have founded that association. Top Breaker on the 3 barrel. He'll be joined by veteran driver Chad Harden and the Sandy Hill Simmental and First Class Cattle Marketing Company. They're regular wholesalers. Check them out online. Mike Ronda and the crew from Logan. I've got some of the best Simmental beef in the business. Chad Harden, former Calgary Stampede champ, goes to that number 2 Fortis Alberta barrel. And that's veteran Roy Romano on that number 1 barrel with Inked Energy. There's a whore and the charge is underway. The stones go in. Outriders mount up and Chad Harden is southbound and out of town. Sandy Hill Simmental in first class cattle marketing and Top Breaker in hot pursuit. Pomeroy Lodging. Barrels are up. Outriders are almost out. And we get into the saddle and he is gone. Into that second turn, it all belongs to Chad Harden, the former Calgary Stampede Chuck Wagon champion, picking his spot along that rail with Top Breaker and Pomeroy Lodging in hot pursuit. He's got to make up some ground. Roy Romano with a shaky start and Inked Energy. Back of our leader by about 3/4 of a furlong. That's how we roll between the final turns. Chad Harden, 22-year veteran, and now Top Breaker trying to close ground, but he's going to run out of racetrack. Head for the home stretch drive. Finish and have it. It's your turn to come alive. We're about to cross the Iron Horse Energy finish line with Chad Harden opening the gap to 2.5 wide lengths over Top Breaker and Pomeroy Lodging. And the turnover is halfway. Roy Romano. Medicine Hat, but a veteran wagon driver up north in the Western Chuck Wagon Association. He brings us Jack Bell and Clo, a leading ISO certified bell distributor. Derek Gately growing up in this sport as well. Family of chuck wagon racers on that number 3 barrel tonight. My spidey senses are tingling. Here comes Spider Electric, a diversified electrical contractor that leads in the oil and gas and industrial electrification. That's Josh Arenick, former Rookie of the Year award winner about 4 years ago, and the Most Improved Driver award winner back in 2019. He's on the 2 barrel. Dean Breaker, you just met his son Top a moment ago. Northern Mat and Bridge, the leaders in access matting, construction, delivery, and Dean Breaker comes to that number 1 barrel, Northern Mat and Bridge. Team number 2, place your bets. Charge is underway. A quick start for Josh Arenick and Spider Electric. Gets him around the barrels tonight. Gets himself down to the far early lead. That brave new horse of his. Home of the outfit out of town. Dean Breaker, Northern Mat and Bridge, down along the rail. And it is Derek Gately with Jack Bell that gets out there. And he's outlined just leaving town. But the barrels are up. That's what I like to see. And here's what's trending in the backstretch drive. Spider Electric, Josh Arenick, ahead of Northern Mat and Bridge, Dean Breaker, and opening up the gap now to 3/4 of the length and leaving him. And in comes Derek Gately to challenge his old buddy, Dean Breaker. They both were stars in the Western Chuck Wagon Association, and they got themselves a horse race. But it's Josh Arenick, Spider-Man, spins his web around that fourth and final turn, and he is southbound. Racing pony chuck wagons all across North America with his papa, Neil Solomon, who's with us this weekend. And he's on that 3 barrel. He'll be joined by Darcy Flatt and Dynamic Industrial Solutions, a professional technological service firm, leaders in patent facilities applications. Darcy Flatt, a veteran of some 18 years on our tour, and his brother Troy Flatt, with friends of Flatt Racing. Flatt boys grew up in Bolo watching their father, Herman Flatt, win many a wagon race. Troy Flatt to that number 1 barrel. Horn sounds, the charge is underway as Wade Solomon rounds the top of that tree barrel and gets out of line. Curry going down to the inside. Darcy Glass to the backside, and that's how they roll out of bounds. Troy's got a barrel now. Wagon tracks all over it as we watch Panerdes driven through the cell from start to finish. And Wade Sullivan rounds that second turn. You can hear the pounding hooves of the Flat Boys going flat out in behind him. Troy Flat's got the rail. Darcy Flat's got the speed around the outside. And Panerdes, Wade Sullivan, hanging on to that lead, but he's about to face a couple of challengers as they get into the final turns with Outriders in tow. Panerdes and Wade Sullivan hanging on to that rail, hanging on to that lead. Now the rail advantage paying off for Troy Flat as well as he inches ahead of his brother Darcy. And that's how he put himself down and down to the Iron Horse Energy finish line. Here he comes. Allowing him to get here. Wade Sullivan by the air, two by the next one. Troy Flat. Darcy Flat rolls on in with Dynamic Industrial Solutions. And that's a wrap by Troy Dorchester. Pure Organic Services, the 1999 Tumor Champion of the WPCA. And the Triple Crown champion in his victory in Kenosha at the Calgary Stampede all in the same year. Going to the number three Magna Barrel. Fortis Alberta brings us the two barrel. Mint Smart Wash brings us Wade Sullivan back again for his second in two wagons here this weekend. Grew up racing Pony Chuck wagons with his dad, Neil. North America wide from Swamp River, Manitoba to Dawson Creek, BC to Houston, Texas. On the number one barrel, Thorsby Stockyard sails every Monday. And Chance Thompson is the man with the plan on that number one GMC barrel in Thorsby Stockyards. He won the top rookie award winner last year. There's a horn and they're off. A good start right across the board is Wade Sullivan to Mint Smart Wash. Smash and dash. Outside runner Troy Dorchester, Pure Organic Services, and Chance Thompson in behind with the Thorsby Stockyards, and the barrels are up. The Outriders are running hard to catch their respective wagons around the turn of the hill. And that Mint Smart Wash Industries in the leader business, leaders in the washing business, he's got him. Wade Sullivan, two lengths ahead of Troy Dorchester, who now starts to close ground with his Pure Camp Services. And now Chance Thompson is closing ground with the Thorsby Stockyards as well, tucked in along the rail. He's trying to sneak inside of Troy Dorchester, who's up the middle of the track. But they cannot catch the Mint Smart Wash tonight. Slash and dash, and he's headed for the cash at the Iron Horse Energy finish line. Wade Sullivan southbound and now opens him up the notch, and Mint Smart Wash rolls into the first by a length of the quarter over Troy Dorchester, a half a length ahead of Chance Thompson. Here comes Lane Flad, giving his mama Darcy a bit ago. Lane Flad and Haranko Industries goes to that number three barrel. He wound up 29th in the aggregate. Now in his third year on a world tour, the year he cracked out was the year he graduated high school. He now attends University of Saskatoon as an engineer student. Lane Flat on that number three barrel. Diamond Dayton Sutherland will bring the feather to the number two barrel. The Manitoba Transport, a full-time outrider and a great young rider driver with a great future in our sport. His granddaddy, Kelly Sutherland, twice a champion here at Medicine Hat, and it is Mitch Sutherland that comes to the Davis GMC wagon on the number one GMC barrel. There's the horn, and the charge is underway. A quick start from Mitch Sutherland on that number one barrel is Davis GMC. Outside, and Diamond Dayton Sullivan, Manitoba Transport, shifted gears, trying to find overdrive when the barrels are up, and we're into that second turn with Big Mitch Sullivan. Davis GMC is about 2.5, 3 lengths ahead of his near, oh no he's not, he's about 2 wagon lengths ahead of Haranko and Lane Flat as they close ground. Dayton Sullivan trying to do the same with Manitoba Transport. His horses didn't start real good when his lead team jumped in the air, but Mitch Sutherland is taking advantage of that. Davis GMC sets him up for the home stretch drive. Medicine Hat, it's your turn to come alive. He's got a two-way life going over Lane Flat. And they're up to the catch. Davis GMC to pick up the fight. He's up the Iron Horse Energy finish line. A length of the quarter. He has Lane Flat on the ring. Denton Sutherland and Manitoba Transport rolls into the third. The last night goes to the number three Wrangler barrel, a 32-year veteran. He wound up 18th here in the aggregate. Lost Hyde, a former star of the Canadian Pro Chuck Fighting Association and the champion outfighter there at the Calgary Stampede. Ross and Gale joined our tour several years ago. Jordy Fyfe, Tackett Contracting, the pipeline and facilities construction inspection professionals. Jordy Fyfe had a granddaddy named Ron Diggle, who won many riding races in his 50-year career. Jordy goes to that number 2 for his Alberta Barrel, challenged by the high-tech redneck, Mark Sutherland, who met his son Dave moments ago. There's the horn, and they're off. Quick start right across the board as outliners get their job done. There goes Mark Sutherland. Brass cap here. Ross Knight around the outside, barrels up, outliners are history, and we've got a survivor rolling into that second turn at a high rate of equine acceleration. That is the high-tech redneck Mark Sutherland, the memorial wagon for Brass Champion. He's got a 2-wagon length lead, and Jordy Fyfe, Tackett Contracting, trying to tack it on him. He's backing up 2 lengths, and then now you see Ross Knight, more short tire, trying to gain some ground. They're reaching their maximum speed when they set up for that home stretch drive. Mark Sutherland with the GPS monitor on his wagon seat. That's why I call him the high-tech redneck. He's at 42, 62 kilometers an hour right now, but he's got comedy coming. Mark Sutherland.
Speed with every stride. You like to find room on that rail.
knows it's a quick run around that third and fourth turn, and we have got Dustin Gorst on a mission. Century Downs Racetrack and Casino rolls the dice, makes the gamble, and he's headed to the Iron Horse Energy finish line with company in coming. Here comes Bruce Bensner up the middle, too little, too late. He's for a racetrack. Dustin Gorst and Chance Brad, a nose ahead of Bruce Bensner at the wire. Wow. Jason Botts, Bridgeclip Energy, the two-time medicine matchup by the champion and four-time world champion, takes him to the number three regular barrel, 10th in the aggregate. And he'll be joined by Lane McGillivray, a third-generation wagon man with Cascade Energy. They've got you covered with their state-of-the-art fleet of diversified units serving the energy industry. Lane McGillivray goes to that number two for the Salvador Barrel, 8th in the aggregate. And Captain Kirk Sutherland here with Davis GMC, running two wagons here this weekend. Kirk sits 9th in the aggregate in this one, and the former world champ. There's the horn and the charge is a quick one right across the board. It's three of the best in the world. Pass their way to the middle way. Checkerboard to the outside. Hurry, Dayton, get them stirrups and get out of here. He is chasing Kirk Sutherland, and Kirk Sutherland is leading the pack with Davis GMC. Leaders in the industry. Kirk has the leaders on the racetrack. Midway down the backstretch now, three quarters of the length ahead of Wayne McGillivray and Cascade Energy. Now those checkerboards starting to make a move, those big distance horses of the Glass family. Jason is rocking and rolling with Bridgeclip Energy, and he's closing ground on our leaders. But Captain Kirk Sutherland, Davis GMC, rounds the fourth and final turn on a burn as he heads for the Iron Horse Energy finish line. The Lowry and Cheater, the quicker move here. Cody McCurry goes to that number three Wrangler barrel, 20th in the aggregate for the award-winning wagon driver. We call him the Hound, who's playing with the Notre Dame Hounds. Sore horse turned left, but Cody pulls on that left line. It is Cattle Prairie, A.T. Sandland, and that's Cody Ridsdale, 2018. We crowned him the Medicine Hat Chuck Wagon Champion on this very weekend. Cody goes to the number two Fortis Alberta barrel, 12th in the aggregate, joined by the Purple Prince himself, Bert Nolan, because drilling and blasting, and that's exactly what they invented. Leaders in the drilling and blasting game. Bert goes to that number one GMC barrel. Hi, Lisa. Welcome back to the track. Goes to that GMC barrel, 21st in the aggregate for a four-time CPCA champion. There's the horn and a flying start for Bert Nolan, because drilling and blasting. Cody Ridsdale pulling up a charge from Cody McCurda on the outside, and we are in hot pursuit of the fastest wagon in the game. That is Vernon Nolan, McCaw's drilling and blasting as he blasted out of those barrels. He's into that back stretch run. Best of company by two wagon lengths, and Cody Ridsdale and Cody McCurda. Ridsdale's got the rail in third. Cody McCurda's up the middle to the outside with his Adventure Enterprises. And they are charging into that third turn and watching the gap widen between them and Bert Nolan as McCaw's drilling and blasting heads for that fourth and final turn on a burn. Southbound and down to the Iron Horse Energy finishes line. Bert Nolan, the Purple Prince, leads the way wire to wire, but his wheels on fire. McCaw's drilling and blasting. They're the winner by 2 3/4. Cody McCurda, a horse length ahead of Cody Ridsdale. And that is a wrap in heat number 10. Chance Bentheller, Pinnacle Victor Services. 2021 Stratmore Chuckwagon Champ, Chance Bentheller. He's taught my buddy Bentheller, taught him well. Chance goes to that number three barrel, lining up 7th in the aggregate. He's joined by Captain Kirk. Kirk Sutherland is back with his main hook. Odds pressure and daily pressure. Kirk goes to that number two barrel. He wound up 5th in the aggregate, less than a split second out of the final three, and he'll be joined by the Duke of Newberry, the reigning Medicine Hat Chuck Wagon champion, is this four-time world champion, Kurt Benzfeller, takes this intimidation to that number one driver, wound up sixth in the aggregate. One of the winningest, well, the winningest wagon driver in the last 5 or 6 years on our tour, with four Calgary Stampede titles and four world titles. There's the horn, and they're off a quick start. It's three of the hottest in the game, past their head to the big frame. Three wagon, the fast southbound and down. Kurt Benzmiller alongside of Kirk Sutherland, and to the outside, Chance Benzmiller letting the rip around the outside of the racetrack here today, and this one is a good one. It's the Benzmiller boys and the Kirk Sutherland sandwich as they come down that backstretch. Kurt Benzmiller on the rail with intimidation, and Chance Benzmiller to the outside of the gate, and that's how they fly. Kirk Sutherland, Naylor pressure, Hodge pressure, he knows what pressure is about now, and the Benzmiller sandwich takes him into that third turn. And now it is Kurt, the Duke of Newberry, that takes his intimidation into the lead for the home stretch drive. Denison Hatt, it's your turn to come alive. Here comes the Duke of Newberry. And Kurt Sutherland in the hot pursuit of Kurt Benzmiller. That's a wire. It will be Kurt Benzmiller. Gets there on two for Kurt Sutherland. And Chance Benzmiller, a little quicker, taking his place in the race. Number 11. Chance Dingin, not only a five-time World Outlawing champ, victories in places like Kiwi Creek and High River last year, Saskatchewan and Dawson Creek, Saskatoon, that is Dawson Creek, Chance Dingin and Brother International, Volker Skellen on three. Aubrey Montalillo, say hello to the reigning world champion. He won it all here in 2014 with his cooperators insurance, your full service insurance professional, with financial advice at every level, and it's Ray Prado Jr., Tornado Products, Projects, that is. There's a fast twist in the barrels from the Tornado Wagon of Ray Prado Jr. There's a whore, and they're off. Ray Prado Jr. quick on the number one barrel. Chance Dingin around the outside. They left the barrel standing and the outriders all bunched up with one mission. Don't be late. We're going to come out of that second turn. The Rainbow Rider is shining today as Ray Prado Jr. takes Tornado Projects midway into that backstretch. A length and a quarter ahead of outside runner Chance Dingin and Glover International. Now the world champ, Aubrey Montalillo. Cooperators Insurance hunting down the stove rack of that Rainbow Rider's chuck wagon as he approaches Ray Prado's wagon at a high rate of equine acceleration. Chance Dingin drops back to the outside with Glover International Boulder stepping. Here they come. The pot of gold for the Rainbow is at the Iron Horse Industry inside. And Ray Prado Jr. will hit there by a horse like that. A little cooperators and Chance Dingin, Boulder stepping and Glover International. He was in the Grand Prairie final earlier on this year. He's a grandson of a guy named Ron David, who was in many of these situations. Chad Fike at the Lost River Ranch, the aggregate winner. Alongside of him, Benoit Oilfield Construction's Chris Molly. He wound up second in the aggregate. He picked barrel two for his run. And Benoit, the Oilfield Benjamin's crew. Chris Molly has been in many final heats in his tour with the Canadian Pro Chuck Wagon Association, even when he joined our tour a couple of years ago. On the number one barrel, Sign Solutions, All Right Signs, Timing Solutions Made Simple. Doug Irvine, who has already won the Grand Prairie Stampede. He's been a champion here in 2016. This is Doug's 10th appearance in the final heat situation. He's won four of them. Chris Molly has been in three finals in Chad Fike. This will be his second final in all this year. There's the horn and the Great West Kenworth Medicine Hat. Doug Irvine, right alongside of him with Sign Solutions, and Chad Fike with the Lost River Ranch, popping in the back. The barrels are up, the outriders are looking good, and we've got us a Great West Kenworth final dash down the backstretch. The inside position with Doug Irvine, a former Medicine Hat champ, wheel to wheel with Chris Molly and Benoit Oilfield. Neither of them give an inch. Chris Molly eases ahead on the outside of Doug Irvine by a nose, and Chad Fike He's pulling a bit, gauging his speed. He needs some running room to find the home stretch drive. And Medicine Hat, it's your turn to come alive. Official results of our Great Quest Kenworth lineup. Third over the wire, Chad Flagg, Lost River Ranch at 103.06. Second over the wire, Doug Irvine, Sign Solutions, 102.46. The winner by 5/100 of a second, Chris Molly, Benoit Oil Deal, 102.41. His winning outliners, Chris and Wendy's son, Kate and Molly, and Brendan Nolan, congratulations. What a great team. And thank you, Medicine Hat Exhibition and Stampede. Thank you, Ron Edwards and Ron Brigden, for those beautiful championship trophy buckles.